Welcome back to an interesting session of polymer chemistry. We know what is a polymer is. Simple monomeric units are combined together to form a macromolecule, which is known as polymer. And polymers have been classified into different types based on their origin, based on their mode of preparation, based on their applicability, and based on the reaction happening to form the polymer. So here, I'm going to discuss about the physical aspects of polymerization technique. Physical aspects of polymerization technique means the method by which a polymer is produced. The method by which a polymer is produced, it is not the mechanism of formation of a polymer. It is a technique by which a polymer is produced. So I'm going to discuss about bulk polymerization here. Bulk polymerization. It is one of the techniques where mostly used polymers have been synthesized. So liquid monomer is used here. That is a specialty with the bulk polymerization technique. Liquid monomer is used, or we can just represent it in a beaker. Like we are adding liquid monomer here. Liquid monomer have been added, and we will be dissolving chain transfer agent. Chain transfer agent is added to the liquid monomer. So first addition will be the liquid monomer, droplets it will be, and we are adding chain transfer agent. So the specialty or the duty of this chain transfer agent is it controls the molecular weight of the polymer to be formed, and we are going to get a homogeneous solution. So continuous agitation of chain transfer agent with the liquid monomer will give you a homogeneous solution of a polymer. So it is heated. Finally, it is heated. Or radiation is passed. Because heat energy or radiation is supplied in order to initiate the reaction or for proceeding the reaction. It is heated at high temperature. Radiation can be microwave radiation, or gamma radiation also can be used for the polymerization reaction, microwave radiation or gamma radiation. So at the same time, when we are passing this microwave radiation or gamma radiation, we have to agitate the mixture continuously, since during the process or the formation of this polymer, viscosity increases. So due to that problem, we have to continuously agitate, or we have to continuously stir the polymer mixture which is being polymerized in that, in order to stop the solidification of this solution. So proper mixing should be done, and the result in difficulty in mixing and broad molecular weight is obtained, which the viscosity increase results in improper mixing or improper agitation of the polymerization mixture or the polymerization solution, and we will get broad molecular weight polymer. We may not be able to get a particular molecular weight polymer there due to this increased viscosity of the polymeric solution. Okay, now what about the advantages of this technique? We have few advantages as well as we have some kind of disadvantages of bulk polymerization technique. So advantages of bulk polymerization technique is it is simple, because we are using the liquid monomer and it is simple to perform, and isolation is not required. Whatever we are getting at the end of the reaction, that will be considered as the product. So no need of isolation. This is one of the advantages with this one, and it is very simple also. So high purity polymers can be obtained, high purity polymer. So this is the advantage with the bulk polymerization technique. With the bulk polymerization technique, we can get simple high purity polymer can be obtained. But as well as there are some disadvantages with this bulk polymerization technique. So what are those disadvantages? Since the reaction gets viscous, we can expect restricted growth of the polymer. The high viscosity will be restricting the polymer from the movement, polymeric chain from the movement. Since the polymerization reaction can stop there itself, and we'll be getting polymer with a different molecular weight. So probability of chain collision is less in that case. As the viscosity increases, agitation speed decreases. So the probability of chain collision will be less, and reaction mixture gets viscous, highly viscous. We can expect restricted growth of the polymer, and the probability of collision, chain collision, is less, and the termination becomes less. Termination becomes less. So if it is going to the termination stage, we'll be getting a high molecular weight polymer there. So less diffusibility, and therefore rate of polymerization increases there. Rate of polymerization increases due to the less diffusibility, and we have high viscous solution there. Termination becomes less due to the high viscosity process, and it causes auto acceleration process also. So sometimes during this polymerization process, it can explode inside the chamber itself. So that is what we call it as auto acceleration process. And now, while moving on to the applications of this one, what are the applications of bulk polymerization? We know that polymethyl methacrylate or polystyrene or polyvinyl chloride resins, etc., are produced by this one, our bulk polymerization technique, where polymethyl methacrylate is used for the manufacture of acrylic sheets, and it is also used in automotive industries and contact lenses, production of contact lenses, and dialysis membrane production. All these are the applications of polymethyl methacrylate sheets. Whereas this polystyrene can be used in food packaging applications and media enclosures like CD cover, manufacture of CD or DVD cover, and it is used for the manufacture of cosmetic bottles or containers. These are the applications of polystyrene. And PVC resins can be used in constructions like building constructions, or it is used in pipes and electronic industries like that. So these are the few polymers that can be produced by this bulk polymerization techniques. And there are many which can be produced by this bulk polymerization techniques. And this is the one technique which I have discussed about the polymerization reaction. So many other techniques have to be discussed, and those will be discussed in the coming classes. Thank you.